Succession is about the unchecked wealthy, the offshoots of capitalism run amok. Just like The Sopranos, The Wire, and Game of Thrones, it is a lot of fun to watch, frequently as funny and audacious as anything TV has cooked up. At its heart, it is an old-fashioned soap opera, but unlike those shows, Succession's plot twists rarely involve sexy complications. Instead, the show finds its pleasure in endless business machinations, in the ways that members of the Roy family compete with each other for dominance, and the ways their competition has scarred them irreparably. In real-world terms, the family is a rough mashup of the Fox News-owning Murdochs and the Paramount-owning Redstones. And just like most modern-day dramas, it borrows a lot from mythology and literature. But it isn't what Succession borrows from mythology and adapts to television that makes it interesting. It's the way it breaks the rules it sets for itself, going forwards and backwards, like a storytelling equivalent of jazz. At the beginning of season 1 of Succession, when Kendall Roy, son of Logan Roy, steps in as temporary CEO, he's informed about the huge debt problem facing the company. The debt has to be repaid if Waystar stock drops below 130. The uncertain status of Logan's health, coupled with the market's lack of faith in Kendall as CEO, causes the stock to do just that. We can state that Kendall's own presence at the helm of Waystar Royco is what causes the stock price to tank, even though Kendall has every intention of saving the company and steer it to more prosperous waters. We see this in episode 1 when Kendall is trying to acquire Walter in an attempt to future-proof Waystar Royco. The story of Oedipus Rex starts in a similar manner, with Oedipus being informed that his kingdom has been stricken by a plague of infertility due to the fact that the kingdom is harboring the killer of its former king. Oedipus, of course, at this point in the story, is unaware that it was he who actually killed the former king, who was also his father. The Succession in season 1 firmly establishes Kendall Roy as its proverbial Oedipus Rex, a tragic hero. We see Kendall occupy this role and try to replace Logan as chairperson and CEO on at least 2 separate occasions in season 1. While his first attempt at a coup is undone by Logan's domination of his board members, the second attempt is foiled largely due to Kendall's drug use. However, where the similarities between Kendall and Oedipus are striking, the differences are unique. The Oedipal archetype deals with any conflict between father and son, particularly where the son must supplant the patriarch or must extricate himself from his father's shadow and find his own place in the world. Much of the time, this presents as the son's aim of removing his father to further himself in the eyes of his mother. However, Succession takes a different route than a lot of other prestige shows and films, focusing instead on the child's need to win the father's approval. This proves to be a complicated terrain because, on the one hand, Kendall and his siblings wish to ascend the throne by winning the patriarch's favor, while on the other hand, Logan refuses to step down from the throne. To further complicate the situation, Logan's brain hemorrhage, as well as his stubborn personality, causes him to make actively harmful business decisions, which makes Kendall genuinely concerned for both the health of his father and the health of the family business. Season 1 ends with Kendall's fall both literally and metaphorically. His drug errand on Siobhan's wedding night ends fatally for his druggy companion, and a long walk back to the wedding venue through the English countryside. Essentially, Kendall's drug habit proves to be his ultimate downfall, handing Logan adequate leverage over him by the end of season 1. While we see Kendall play the proverbial Oedipus in season 1, season 2, however, shows us a very different Kendall. We see him undergo Yayati complex. What is the Yayati complex? Tales in Hindu scripture suggests a reverse Oedipal or Yayati complex. In this case, the father destroys the son in order to have his way. The story goes that Devyani learned that her husband Yayati had secretly married her maid Sarmishtha, and the maid had borne him 2 sons. Devyani ran to her father, the priest Shukra, who cursed Yayati to become old and impotent. When he realized the implications of the curse, Shukra modified it, stating that Yayati would regain his youth and potency if one of his sons willingly bore the burden of the curse. The youngest son Puru agreed to become old and impotent so that his father could enjoy life. With Kendall declaring his loyalty to his father at the beginning of season 2, Kendall is established as a reverse Oedipal or the proverbial Puru. Kendall does his father's bidding throughout season 2, even going as far as gutting Walter and rejecting an actress from Vila's play he becomes romantically involved with due to his father's disapproval. Puru regained his youth and earned the gratitude of his father years later when, after indulging his senses in every which way, Yayati finally realizes the ephemeral nature of material things and decides that it is time to let go and grow old. This was never a possibility with Logan, whose win at all costs prison yard bully mentality makes him incapable of this realization that was gained by Yayati at the end. At the end of season 2, when Logan says,
"You have to be a killer,"
Kendall finally realizes that gaining the approval of his father and dethroning him by any means possible might not be mutually exclusive. What do you think will Kendall undergo in season 3? Will Logan finally relinquish the throne, or will we see an all-out war break out between the father-son duo? Let me know in the comments.